All right, we're all ready to get these ends faced off on the cylinders, and we're going to use a 3/4 arbor. This is going to slip on there like that. We'll be able to reach in and face that, and this end will be on the lathe, toward the lathe, and engage on the chuck, the dog, and this will be offset 180 degrees from the dog arm to help with imbalance issues, if there's any at all. There usually is a little bit because your arm is so far out. I just have a piece of scrap tool steel in here. Actually, it's a W1. That's a half inch or so. We're just going to put a 60 degree point on, then we're going to slip it back into the chuck a little bit, and then we'll just touch it up and true it up so we have concentric center. All right, now we're going to push that. Just going to push that back in there a little ways. And we want to make sure that's going to catch, and that's looks like a good spot. Sure, we got room to get our tool up here. That looks just fine. We could probably slip this tailstock a little closer. There we go. Offset that a little bit. I think that tight enough. All right, I think we're set. We got a nice fresh ground tool. And we're going to reach in there up like that. And we got good clearance on everything. I have to always make sure you have clearance. I think we're good. Let's give her a go. We've got the ends turned, and I'm pretty happy with how they came out. They came out good. Well, I had to deburr around the center because of the piece that's a little bit of flash that be left from that was against the arbor. Yeah, but they came out really nice. And just our links are 16905 and 16905. So I think they're both the same or pretty darn close. they came out really good, so I'm pretty happy about that. Next will be, we'll get these decked off and to their dimension, and that dimension is going to be from the center point of your bore out is 800 thousandths. Then we'll have to drill, counter bore, drill and tap holes, and we have our porting to do. Thanks, you guys. Thanks for watching.